My name is Yifan, an advanced practice nurse, and I'm happy to present this topic together with Dr. Tu Tianming, a stroke neurologist, and both of us are from National Neuroscience Institute. Over the course of this presentation, we will be focusing on how to take a history in stroke and transient ischemic attack with a focus on excluding stroke mimics. At the end of this presentation, you have learned how to take a focused history to identify stroke, able to differentiate what is stroke and transient ischemic attack, how to identify a stroke mimics. Acute stroke is an emergency. Treatments are available emergently and has to be instituted early for outcomes. There are two major subtypes of strokes, with ischemic stroke as the most common, where approximately 80% of all strokes are ischemic in nature. Time is brain. Every minute of untreated ischemic stroke results in the death of 2 million brain cells. Treatment options such as intravenous thrombolysis and endovascular therapy are available for ischemic stroke. However, these treatments are only beneficial if patients present early for ischemic stroke and unsuitable in the late stage. Moreover, these treatments carry certain degree of risk, such as intracerebral hemorrhage. Stroke remains a clinical diagnosis. Hence, taking a good history and performing a focused clinical examination to confirm stroke is crucial. Additionally, exclusion of stroke mimic is essential to avoid unnecessary treatment.
Stroke can present with varied symptoms. Many diseases can also mimic stroke symptoms. Taking a focused history helps to reasonably arrive at the diagnosis of stroke. In stroke, where time to treatment is important for good outcomes, arriving at the correct diagnosis with certainty and speed are important. The acronym of OLCART helps one to take a focused yet comprehensive history to confirm the presence of stroke. In particular, the onset of stroke or the timing where the patient was last seen well helps the clinician to decide on the most suitable treatment. In addition, the presented symptoms such as weakness, numbness, giddiness, helps to confirm the type of stroke syndrome that the patient is experiencing. In addition, other pertinent information include alleviating and relieving factors for the neurological symptoms may point to stroke mimics, such as migraine or hypoglycemia. The patient's past medical and surgical history, such as recent surgery or even a recent stroke, may contraindicate some of the patients to available stroke treatments. Patient's current medication list, such as anticoagulation medications, also helps the clinician to decide on the suitability of treatment. In addition to the history taking, one will also perform a clinical examination to identify the features that are consistent with the suspected stroke syndrome. These include left or right hemispheric syndromes, lacunar syndromes such as pure motor, pure sensory, sensory motor, ataxic hemiparesis or clumsy hand dysarthria, or posterior circulation syndromes such as lateromedullary syndrome. As part of the examination, it is also important to assess the severity of stroke with a validated standardized stroke scale. This scale has to be understood by all clinicians caring for stroke patients. The stroke scale that we use is the National Institutes of Health Stroke Scale, which comprises of 11 different examination findings. With this stroke scale, we can communicate the severity among clinicians, and this helps with the management of the patients subsequently. Nevertheless, even with a comprehensive history and clinical examination, how sure are we that the patient in front of us is indeed suffering from a stroke?
Stroke is defined as a neurological deficit that causes an acute focal injury of the central nervous system by a vascular cause. There must be a cell death due to ischemia based on pathological, imaging, or other objective evidence. Transient ischemic attack is defined as a transient episode of neurological dysfunction caused by a focal central nervous system ischemia without acute infarction or cell death. The following flow sheet articulates the diagnostic algorithm of ischemic stroke and transient ischemic attack. Ischemic stroke is diagnosed in the presence of neurological symptoms resulting from focal arterial occlusion and the presence of radiological imaging evidence of cell death. This radiological evidence includes a positive CT or MRI scan of the brain. The diagnosis of transient ischemic attack will only be fulfilled if there is no radiological evidence of cell death and resolutions of neurological symptoms within 24 hours. In the absence or unavailability of radiological investigations, the clinical diagnosis of transient ischemic attack will solely be based on clinical symptoms lasting less than 24 hours. As part of the ischemic stroke clinical spectrum, in an event when a patient does not present with any clinical stroke symptoms, but incidental infarction is found over radiological investigations, this clinical scenario can be considered as a silent stroke.
Now we'll move on to stroke mimics. Stroke mimics presents like a stroke, but are not due to vascular causes. Patients with acute stroke, rapid intervention is crucial to maximize early treatment benefits. Hence, to correctly identify stroke and to exclude stroke mimics are crucial. According to the evidence, stroke mimics can account for up to 21% of all stroke presentations. Hence, having a reliable clinical tool to exclude stroke mimics may be helpful. Even in the best centers, it is inevitable that sometimes even stroke mimics are treated with stroke treatments such as thrombolytics. Nevertheless, the acceptable international rate of error in treatment should be below 3%. There are many causes of stroke mimics. One of the most common medical causes is hypoglycemia. Due to the high prevalence of diabetic patients on oral hypoglycemic agents in the community, screening for hypoglycemia is critical with patients presenting with acute neurological deficits. In patients with seizures with post-ictal paralysis, they may also present with weakness that looks like a stroke. In patients with migraine with aura, they can present with sudden onset of weakness during or even after the onset of their migraine. Other rarer causes such as hypertensive encephalopathy, central nervous system abscesses or tumors may cause stroke-like symptoms. Drugs is always a consideration as many drugs can cause weakness or numbness that presents acutely with toxicity. In a subgroup of patients, they can present with stroke-like symptoms but are psychogenic in origin and not due to any vascular occlusion at all. There are many clinical skills that have been developed to identify stroke or exclude stroke mimics in the emergency department. One of the most validated skills to help to identify stroke is the recognition of stroke in the emergency room score, also known as the Rozier score. The Rozier score comprises of clinical variables such as asymmetrical facial, leg and arm weakness, speech disturbances, and visual disturbances. While the Rozier score is good at screening for stroke patients, it is not good excluding stroke mimics with certainty. Other scores have been developed for the purpose of identifying stroke mimics in patients already considered for stroke treatments. These include the FABS score, the facial droop, no atrial fibrillation, normal blood pressure, presence of seizures, and isolated sensory finding. Other scores include the Guangzhou Stroke Scale, which was a score developed from Chinese patients for the purpose of excluding stroke mimics. However, Applying all these scores may be difficult as many clinical parameters are required and may not be utilized in the real-world setting. Additionally, these scales have not been reliably validated across different communities. So which scale should we use? Unfortunately, none of the scores are highly reliable, and available guidelines do not recommend the use of any of these scales to exclude stroke mimics. What does this leave us? This means that the clinical diagnosis of stroke is still based on a focused history and clinical examination, and clinical diagnosis is still key to guide on stroke treatments in our patients.
In summary, acute stroke is life-threatening and time-sensitive diagnosis. It remains a clinical diagnosis. Transient ischemic attack is similar to stroke but without evidence of cell death on the imaging. Consider causes of stroke mimic systematically when you approach patients with stroke symptoms. We hope that you have learned the basic importance of identified stroke and stroke mimic from these presentations. Thank you.